See, the word gives you the definition. If I take compute is computer, this compute is the basis of computer. This computing, because computer is a computing device. Initially, if you remember, Charles Babbage created it, and it was basically to do certain computation automatically in a faster way, and some mathematical problems, some general problem that can be solved, right? So it was a big room when Charles Babbage created, a lot of heat, big room, lot of electromechanical and these electronic devices. So computer system is a programmable machine. So what is the main work of this computer system? First is, it has to do certain work. That is, if you give arithmetic logic operation, for example, I'll just take a small example. 2 plus 3 equals 5. You know, calculator also does that. But 2 plus 3 computation it has to do, and also this 5 it has to store as well. Okay? So computer system is a machine that is being made to do certain computation, to make your life comfortable, to do your all computation in a faster and logical way. And then whatever data is there, it need to store also. And you can retrieve also later. So there are three main parts of a computer. The main part is central processing unit. This box which you are witnessing is a CPU. When I was first subjected to this CPU, or I saw the computer, I saw this whole box is a computer, this CPU. But basically it has multiple devices inside it. For example, it has a motherboard, it has a processor. That processor is the brain of this computer. You know, only processor won't do anything, or wouldn't be able to do anything. You need to have a RAM, you have to have a hard disk, you have to have, say, SMPS, the power supply. So there are so many things which are inside this CPU. But the idea is all about the processor, computing device. All the computation and operations are done here. So if you have to input this 2 and 3, how to input this 2 and 3? You need to have some input device. We'll talk about all the input devices. Just beginning, just assume that you have to input this 2 and 3 inside your computer or computing device. This is your input unit. Now this 2 plus 3 goes inside your CPU, all the operations are done, and then 5 comes out. So how to see this 5? You need to have an output device. So previously it was CRT monitor, then different type of LCD, LED, all these have come. So desktop computers, which you see here, which is in this picture, this is your table. My drawing is not that good, but still, this is a table. Now you put certain electronic devices, computing devices on your desktop, on your desk, that on the top of the desk. So that is why it is called desktop. The word has come from here only. You're putting these on your desk, on the top. Similarly, the laptop, the computing device which is placed on your laps, it's laptop, on your laps. In desktop computers, I just told you that there are three units, separate devices in desktop computer. So what do you have? Keyboard will be different. A box that is called the CPU. As I said, it has RAM, ROM, and processor, power unit, and the motherboard, the hard drives. These are the content of a CPU. This is called the central processing unit, a box. The result will be shown in the monitor, which is the video display unit. So this whole is called a computer, right? Now if you see on the back, there are different ports here. Today we have ports in the front also. The size of this box which you see is a form factor. If I make it smaller, the form factor will be small. The size is called the form factor. So you enter certain data, certain instruction, and this instruction is understood by the computer. For example, 2 plus 3 is 5 and 5 plus 6 has to be 11. These are the instruction, these are the data 5 and 6 you are giving. Instruction is that you have to add. This all program are written in C, C++, Python, the assembly languages, everything is there. Different programming languages. So what instructions you give? What output you get? The desired format you want? So this is all the combination because these are certain instructions. I'll just give you a very simple example. Let us take a C++, say input. Okay? Say Cout you have. This is just a simple program, set of instructions which I am trying to tell you. What are the instructions? For example, enter numbers. If these two numbers are coming, we will take it in Cn, Cin. A and B will take, A and B. And then C equals A plus B. And then we'll do Cout. That is printing. Cout is for printing, Cin is for inputting. C equals A plus B is the computation part. You don't worry about this program. It is just to show how the instruction looks. How the coder programmer makes program. So now I'm talking about the CPU, this box. In laptop, there is no separate CPU or a video or the input device. In mobile also. Today we have everything in a mobile or a tablet. So coming back to CPU, CPU has a control unit. It has the second part as arithmetic logical unit, ALU. And the third is memory unit. Now let us take a real life example. There is a company. Okay? So whenever you go inside, there will be a receptionist. And there will be a certain manager. So when you go inside, there will be a receptionist. Reception will be handling certain thing. Manager will be handling people and the stuff. Okay? So the manager and receptionist are kind of, their work is to control the company, the work of the company. Whoever is coming, the stock is coming, or whom has to be provided what job, given what job. So this is the all the instruction they are taking, and they are coordinating with different parts, the part of the company or people to perform certain operation the way company wants. So this is this receptionist and a manager. You can together call them as control unit. Okay. Now coming to accountant, what is his work? Accountant. Now 2 plus 3 is an accounting work. So the accounting work is all the computation work. Okay. So this is just a basic computation. The today's computer, they are doing high end, you know. We have supercomputers also. We have high end workstations also. So this is all the mathematical and logical calculation which an accountant does. And this is the this part, ALU, your accountant. Now coming to the store manager of the company. The store manager or store officer of the company, he is basically responsible for storing temporary storage or the permanent storage. Temporary storage is in RAM, permanent is in your hard drive. So you'll tell, he'll say, oh, yesterday I had a consignment. Now the manager is asking or the client is asking, he'll just retrieve it. Storage. So when you take all these units, combine them, it becomes laptop, right? Laptop can be folded. It's low in weight. That is 3 kg around and more than that. So when you combine this, it will become a laptop. So you have to combine input unit, output unit, CPU. You combine this in a laptop. So this input output, we all also count them in a computer as a peripheral. Why they are called as a peripheral? See, tablet, mobile, or whatever. You need to connect certain devices. For example, your earphone. Earphone, you always plug in into your mobile to listen to the songs, to talk. So this, your earphone or mic is the peripheral device. Periphery means, peripheral has come from the word periphery. Periphery is basically the boundary. So you have in center your device, computing device, all other things which can be connected to this boundary or in this periphery, which can be connected, they're called as peripheral devices. They are plugged into the computer and there are different connection ports. You have USB port, you have HDMI port. So they have different technology, different connection, different input, output, this is different power levels. So you have different ports, and every port has certain specification, and this specification is used for connecting different devices. And these devices, which can be connected to a computer, to your laptop, to your mobile, is called as peripherals. Okay?